The plans for Gennady next? I know you have the best.
There's only one person that decides the plans for Gennady, and that's Gennady.
Yeah.
So I think he's going to have a mandatory at some point, which will have to be designated. His hand's badly bruised. In fact, I just got a call then to say both guys have gone to hospital, so neither will be joining us at the press conference, I'm afraid. But he's got to, you know, I think February was the plan originally, but it was a very tough fight. His hand's damaged, and maybe he won't be ready for February. You know, it was a war.
Or
the rematch. Yeah, I think the rematch is a huge fight. Huge fight.
Your client Andrade would want to
in the ring. He wanted the fight as well. Yeah. You know, he's that's a unification fight now. That's a matchup. I think it, everything depends on Gennady. You know, I think that it's very difficult to for me to stand here and start saying he should do this, he should do that. He's a legend. So he came up to me in the ring. He was like, what?
When he was a tough fight.
Yeah, I mean, he was exhausted. I mean, he's gone to the hospital. Sergey's gone to the hospital. They're absolute, both two complete warriors. And they deserve so much respect. And I think maybe a fight again, like, you know, it's like, I'm sitting there at some point thinking about Joshua Ruiz. Like, you know, I think it was like the fifth or sixth round when it started to swing a little bit. I just thought, God, not again. And it was the same kind of level of underdog in the fight that just produced something special at a place like this, and that's what happened to the guy. No, it's just it was a fight that was always, no rematch calls either way.
But it's going to be talked about.
Yeah, I think so. It depends on Gennady. You know, I think, look, some people felt that Derevyanchenko won the fight, some people thought Gennady won the fight, whatever. So if there's any doubt, he's the kind of guy that might want to do it again. You know, don't mean to be disrespectful to Sergey, but Gennady wasn't overly motivated to fight Sergey Derevyanchenko. It's no excuse. But at this age, you know, at this stage in his career, really you need those fights that will motivate you. And what he came up against tonight was a guy that was super motivated. You know, who basically fought with every ounce that he's got. And sometimes it's tough if you're not ready for that. Right. You know, and it was a brutal war.
Do you feel like the 12th round had the difference in the fight?
I felt that going into the 12th round, I thought you really like actually. I had him winning actually the 11th and 12th. Everybody had him winning the 12th, I think, on the scorecards. I think two had him winning the 11th or something. But I said to him going after the 10th round, I was just screaming at him saying, two rounds, win these two rounds, and I felt he did. And
except you're wrong, baby.
Well, I don't know.
You're wrong, man.
It's not always just according to you.
No, but I just think you're wrong.
Well, it's called subjective.
It is subjective, yeah. But I think most of the people in the room know who won. And it wasn't Triple G tonight.
Not necessarily.
Lou, how'd you score it?
8-4.
He scored 8-4.
Very easily. On rounds, yes.
Oh, with a knockdown? And him winning the last two.
No. 8-4 in rounds. There was obviously another point on the knockdown, so I didn't have a 4-point fight. I had it a 3-point fight.
So, Lou, you think you got robbed?
Man, I don't want to use that. You know, here's what I think. I think the Triple G is a great, great, great fighter, and he's had all these moments in his life to cement his legacy.
Mm-hmm.
Tonight, Derevyanchenko cemented his legacy, and he was robbed of that moment.
Mm.
Okay, I'm not going to talk about that, but he was robbed of that moment. And it made me feel sick, because that was like a Gaddy Ward fight fought at a skill level like 10 levels above. But just tonight, it wasn't Triple G's night, and I think he knew it. I love Triple G, one of the greatest fighters of all time. But he knows he didn't win tonight. I believe that.
Not true, but
anyway. Well, Eddie, I saw Andre right after the fight. He seemed very frustrated,
because he gets in the ring. Gennady's just had an absolute war.
Yeah.
And Demetrius is going up to him saying, come on, let's fight.
Okay,
and he's like, whoa. And he actually said to him, I'm ready to fight you.
Okay.
You've got a belt, I've got a belt, let's do the unification. So I wouldn't be surprised to see that fight next.
Do you think Andre, in a sense, is too good? Because he's always had a problem getting these big fights.
Styles make fights, you know. Again, Derevyanchenko boxed so well tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody has their night, you know. Sometimes, mm-hmm. you know, Andre could go in against Gennady and just dazzle.
Right.
You know, he could walk onto a shot, could get hurt to the body. Like anything can happen. That's why we love boxing. You know, and styles make fights. And what Derevyanchenko did tonight, a lot of the time, was push Gennady back. So he followed a little bit of the blueprint from Canelo in the second fight,
mm-hmm.
where it was like, okay, rather than let him walk you down and cut you off, let's try and take the initiative. And I was screaming at Gennady to walk him down and cut him off.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it was a very, very close fight. I know Lou felt it was 8-4, but not including the knockdown. So obviously got it by one point. So what's it, a robbery by 1 point? I mean,
most writers have Price Row. I talked to had Sergey win the fight.
Yeah, I've seen
that's
that.
Fact. Dan Rayfield had it for him.
By one round.
But he won the fight. He won the fight. Coppinger had it for him. Keith Ionek, Lance Pugmire, every single one of those guys scored it for Sergey Derevyanchenko. And the knockdown of the first round wasn't just one shot in the back of the head, it was two shots. Two, clear as day.
Because he's down here like this. Because
doesn't matter.
He's ducking down
doesn't
his
leg.
Of course it does.
Doesn't matter. He was hitting behind the head the whole fight. The referee warned him three times.
Because he was
nobody. He warned him three times. The referee warned him three times. Other times he wasn't knocked down. The fact is, when they were being interviewed in the ring after the fight, the entire crowd booed Triple G. And then when Sergey got interviewed, they cheered Sergey. So obviously, the writers, most of the public had Sergey winning the fight. If he doesn't fight Canelo next, there should be a rematch with Sergey Derevyanchenko. Because I don't think anybody in the public, except for a Canelo fight, wants to see any other fighter fight Triple G except for Sergey.
I disagree.
Okay.
There's a unification with Demetrius Andrade.
Demetrius Andrade is a great fighter.
There's your other client, Daniel Jacobs.
Daniel Jacobs moved up to 168. He'll fight Triple G at 160 or 168 as well.
How does Sergey feel? Because he's had two really close, really tough fights for the world title that he just didn't go his way. Is he a little...
He's heartbroken.
Okay.
His wife's heartbroken. And that's the problem when you have fights like this where, I'm not going to say it was a robbery, but most people, most writers, and obviously with the reaction of the crowd, most people think Sergey Derevyanchenko won the fight. I'm not saying that everybody thought it, but most people think he won the fight, so you steal the guy's career from him. He'll have a great career after this, but this would have been career changing, and that's wrong.
I think I thought it was a very close fight. I think Keith knows, because he told me that Golovkin shouldn't really been in a ring tonight, but I can't take anything away from Derevyanchenko's performance.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Excuse me?
Do you agree with him that Triple G shouldn't have been in the ring tonight?
Well, I don't manage.
Somehow they found out he was ill.
Listen, I don't manage Golovkin. It was his choice to fight. Okay, other people have been sick before and gone in the ring. You have to ask him. I'm not going to comment. Maybe he was sick. Okay, but all I know is every time he hit Sergey with a huge combination, Sergey would fire back with the same amount of punches. Every single time. There was never a time where he got hit with a huge combination that he wouldn't fire back. So he proved he's one of the best middleweights in the world. And again, I don't want to say a robbery because it sounds like sour grapes, but I know my guy won. And the crowd and Press Row and even DAZN, the company that signed Triple G to they signed him to a $100 million contract. He's one of the faces of their franchise. They scored it for Sergey Derevyanchenko. So if Eddie wants to say there shouldn't be a rematch, maybe he thinks Derevyanchenko is too dangerous.
If you're working with Triple G, there shouldn't be a rematch.
We'd like him 100% healthy for the rematch.
With all due respect, they're both in the hospital, so we want them both 100% healthy.
Okay, so then if he was sick tonight, if he was legitimately sick, let's do the rematch. Let's do it. I don't think there's anybody. Is there anybody in this room right here that doesn't want to see a rematch? Raise your hand. If you don't want to see a rematch. Okay. Except that.
Rematch with new judges.
Yeah. Who do you think won the fight?
You already know. Triple G ain't winning that.
All right.
Hell no.
Press Row doesn't have him winning either. So there should be a rematch.
Well, you didn't even ask people. I mean, okay. This guy here was like, well, I don't think so, but you know.
Yeah, it went either way for me.
With the issue of the illness, right? In his last two fights, Derevyanchenko failed to score above 25% hit rate against his opponents. Triple G obviously made him look very good in here. You think that really, that illness?
Sergey made Sergey look really good.
Yeah, Triple G didn't make anybody look good.
Sergey fought his ass off. Again, every time Sergey got hit with some monster hooks, some monster shots to the body, some monster shots to the back of the head, and what did he do every time that happened? He fired back with a 3-4 punch combination. He never retreated. He always fought back. Okay, so there's not one person in here that doesn't want to see a rematch.
Triple G's never been hit with shots like that, ever, including against Canelo. If he didn't have the chin of God, he would have been knocked out in that fight. He has the chin of God. He's the greatest chin in boxing. There's no question about it. He took bombs tonight that were unbelievable.
Both guys showed great heart. So, I mean, listen, there's a million great fights. You know, all these guys could fight each other. Andrade, Sergey, Triple G, Canelo, Danny Jacobs. Every single one of those fights is amazing, but Sergey Derevyanchenko deserves a rematch. Or, if he goes and fights Canelo next, because I'm sure Canelo wants to fight him now, we should get the winner of that fight.
Well, given the fact that Triple G is not a champion, was there a rematch clause in the fight?
No,
it's a mandatory fight.
So what would it take him to even take the second
because
fight?
Because he's a man's man,
yeah, that's why.
He knows that, look, Keith is right, some people had Derevyanchenko winning it. If Gennady will know that. And maybe he wants to fight him again.
You know what?
Know what he wants. He wants the Canelo fight.
You got to remember something too. Gennady and Derevyanchenko have known each other and who they are and what they're about for years and years and years. Triple G took this fight because he's a man's man. He knew it. He knew he was in for a war. He knew it. Believe me, this is not a fight he was dying to have. He wanted the belt.
And both guys fought great. Triple G fought a great fight too. Sergey fought a great fight. It was either the fight of the year or pretty damn close to it. So there should be a rematch. If he fights Canelo next, obviously, everybody wants to see that. That makes sense. But if he doesn't fight Canelo next, he should be fighting Sergey Derevyanchenko. Because Sergey Derevyanchenko deserves it.
You know, the blood, the pain.
Why stop at calling it a robbery? Why not call it a robbery? Why not?
Because I don't want to sound like sour grapes.
You know what? Because it wasn't.
But he won the fight, clearly. It wasn't a robbery, but he clearly won the
fight. He won the fight. I'm going to disagree, bro. He won the fight. Legitimately, it is subjective. And people make mistakes. No, I thought he won the fight. I really did. I thought he clearly won. I know who won that fight, and I'm always going to believe it was
Derevyanchenko.
Lou, I don't really want to start an issue with this, but did you have an issue with the ref? Because he seemed to step in a couple times.
Yeah, I mean, I don't have an issue with his intention. I don't think he was trying to fuck the fight up. I don't think he had a good night. Harvey's a good referee. I don't think he had a great night.
By the way, I think the commissioner and the doctors did a great job of that.
They did. They did, yeah.
And I was worried they'd stop the fight. Yeah. And I wanted to
see nobody should boo either guy.
I agree.
You said both fighters went to
They weren't booing either guy.
Right. Yeah,
they weren't booing Triple G. They were booing the result.
So with both fighters,
they weren't booing Triple G. They weren't. They were No, they were booing what they thought was an unjust decision. They were not booing Triple G. No one can boo Triple G. He's one of the greatest fighters ever caught in the game.
And he's still one of the greatest fighters.
He's still
any comments from the fight?
But now Sergey is as well.
Can I go to bed, please? All right.
Thank
you. They was in the hospital together, like Mickey Ward again.
Well, they probably will be. I see Sergey, he had a big bandage. His hands was like this. Respect to both.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Great fight.
Thank you.
I think it was better to spend.